Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Skillset Go. So in the previous video we have seen the introduction of compiler in a computer. So in this video we will see the number of phases that compiler will go through to convert the higher level languages to a lower level language. So we will see the phase and what analysis it does in that phase. So let's go to the phases and let's see what is the purpose of that phase. So there are number of phases of compiler. So the first one is lexical analysis. So what is lexical analysis? So it will just read the code character by character and identify the lexemes, also known as tokens. So in this phase it will identify if it has any lexical errors. It means in every program there will be some tokens or some names of the variables and other keywords. So if you use any special characters in that token or keywords, then the program will fail, because we can't use special characters in a variable name, and you can see that in so many programs. So those kind of errors will be identified in lexical analysis. It will just read character by character and identify the token, and it finds any lexical failure or lexical error exists in the token. If it's not exist, it will just produce all the tokens into a file. So we can take an example of statement sum equal to old sum plus rate into some 50. Let's take this is a statement. So it will read a character by character and it will identify the tokens. So the output of lexical analysis will be, it will read this token, and if it doesn't have any error, it will just note id1 equal to id2 plus id3 into id4. So it will just take every token and keep it as a output. So this one is also equal to plus, and into is also like token for this phase. So what is the next phase in the compiler? So the next phase is syntax analysis. So the name itself says syntax. So in this phase it will find any syntax errors exist in the statement or in a code. So you all know what is a syntax analysis. Means if you don't have any character, or so many times we will get a semicolon error, we missed semicolon at the end of the statement in Java language, and if you use two variables side by side without giving any operator in between, again it will fail. It is a syntax error, because we can't have id1 and id2 without any operator in between. So these are all the syntax errors. So those kind of errors will be identified in this phase, the syntax analysis. So what will be the output of syntax analysis? So it will take these tokens and it will form a tree structure. The syntax analysis will give output as, so we need to get the result of id1. So the result of id1 equal to id2 plus the remaining statement. id2 plus the remaining. So what will be the remaining? Id3 into id4. So it will just form a tree structure based on these tokens and the operators. So what will be the next phase in a compiler? It will be semantic analysis. So what the semantic analysis do means, suppose if you have any errors like we can't assign integer to float, or we can't assign double to string, or we can't assign string to integer. So those kind of errors will be identified in semantic analysis phase. Suppose if you are trying to add integer and a string, then it is a semantic error. So logically it is not correct to add an integer and a string. So that is a semantic error. So those kind of errors will be identified in this phase. So I have given an example. There are so many like that in a semantic analysis errors. So those will be identified in this phase, and it will form a one more tree structure, also known as annotated tree structure. So in annotated tree structures, we will have the values of these IDs wherever possible. So if you see, the ID 4 is equal to 50. So the semantic analysis, at last we will get a tree structure which will have values for these IDs wherever possible. So what will be the output of semantic analysis in this case? So this is a variable, this is a variable, this is a variable, and this is a constant, and the value is available. So here we will get 50, and this is the output of semantic analysis. So what is the next phase after semantic analysis? That is intermediate code generation. Intermediate code generation. So up to these three errors, we have identified all the errors related to the compiler while compiling. So all the token errors will be identified in this phase, all the syntax errors will be identified in this phase, all the semantic analysis will be identified in this phase. So from here onwards, we will try to generate a code, a lower level code, out of this output from the semantic analysis. So intermediate code generation. So here we have got a tree. So based on this, we will form an intermediate code generation. So this one is 50. So we will take a temporary variable temp1 equal to 50. Then ID2. So here we will get a temporary value if you multiply this ID3 and 50. And 50 is nothing but temp1. So temp2 4. So this is the intermediate code we will get based on this tree. So what is the next phase in after intermediate code generation? That is code optimization. So if you see this code, there are so many statements, and there are so many redundant statements, we can optimize it. So those optimizations will be done in this phase, code optimization. So here you can see we assigned 50 to temp1. Instead of that, we can directly write 50 here, and we can exclude this statement. And here if you observe, we assign temp3 to temp4 and again temp4 to id1. This is also redundant. Instead of that, we can directly assign temp3 to id1, and this one also we can exclude. So like this, we can optimize the code wherever possible, and that optimization will be done in this code optimization phase. So what will be the next phase in code optimization, after code optimization? That is the actual code generation. So this intermediate code or optimization code will be converted to the code in a assembly language. Like if you have any languages like microprocessor language. So in those things we will have the keywords like add, multiply, subtract, and we will provide the variables here. So this intermediate code will be finally converted into this language, that is the lower language. So these are the phases involved in a compiler, and these three phases are identifying any errors like lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis, and from here onwards we will try to generate a code based on that. Intermediate code generation and code optimization, and finally the code generation. So I hope you liked this video and understood the phases and each phase what exactly the compiler do. In the next video we will learn more about the compilers. I hope you like this video. Please share and subscribe my channel to your friends. Thank you for watching.